गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द टोटल प्रोडक्ट, मार्जिनल प्रोडक्ट एंड एवरेज प्रोडक्ट एंड हाउ टू कैलकुलेट टोटल प्रोडक्ट, मार्जिनल प्रोडक्ट एंड एवरेज प्रोडक्ट. सो व्हेन इट कम्स फॉर द लेबर, सो वी विल टेक लेबर एज अ 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is the number of labor which we are going to take. Now let us suppose they have given the total product. So we have to find out the marginal product and average product. Total product is given. Total product is when the labor is 0, it is 0. When the labor is 10, when the labor is 1, the total product is 10. When the labor is 2, the total product is 24. When the laborers are 3, the total product is 40. And when the labor is 4, the total product is 50. When the labor is 5, the total product is 56. And when the labor is 6, the total product is 57. It is just the number which is given for us to do the calculation. So now we have to find out the marginal product and average product. So what is the formula to find out the marginal product? That is change in the input divided by the change in output. That is marginal product of labor is equal to delta TPL divided by delta L. So delta TPL, so the difference between the labor and output. Output means the total product. So now suppose we have to find out the marginal product for the first commodity. So when there is a zero labor and zero output, the marginal product is going to be zero. So now what will be the next one? So next you have to do the difference between these two. So 10 minus 0, it is going to be 10 divided by 1 minus 0, it is going to be 1. 10 divided by 1 is equal to 10. So here it will come as a 10. Now, difference is between these two. 24 minus 10, what is the difference? 14. 14 divided by 2 minus 1, 1. 14 divided by 1 is equal to 14. So it will be 14. So next one. 40 minus 24. 40 minus 24, how much it will come? 16. Divided by 3 minus 2. It is 1. Is equal to 16. So next one. 50 divided by 40. It is 10. So 10 divided by 4 minus 3. 1. Is equal to 10. So here again it is going to come as 10. So now 56 minus 50, what is the difference? 6. And 5 minus 4, it is 1. Again it is going to be 6. Now 57 minus 56, what is the difference? 1. 6 minus 5, 1. 1 divided by 1 is equal to 1. So like this we are going to calculate marginal product. I hope you are clear how we are going to calculate marginal product. Now we have to do the calculation for the average product. When labor and total product are 0, automatically the average product also going to be nil, because when there are no labors, when there is no capital, no output, that time there will be no average product. So what is the formula to find out the average product? It is AP is equal to total product of labor divided by labor. Total product of labor divided by the labor. So how to calculate now? Now we have to see the labors and total product. So now suppose the first one we are going to find out when labor is 1. So now here the labor is 1. What is the total product? It is 10. So here we are going to write it as a 10. 10 divided by 1 is equal to 10. So it will be, average product will be 10. So next, second one, 24. 24 divided by 2. How much labor they have used? 2 labors they have used. So 24 divided by 2, how much it will come? 12. So it will be 12. Next, third one, how much is the output? It is 40, total production. How much labor they have used? It is 3. 40 divided by 3, how much it will come? 13.33. So it will be 13.33. Now next one, their output is 50. How much labor they have used? 4. 50 divided by 4, how much it will come? 12.5. So it will be 12.5. Next, the output is 56. And the labor which they have used, it is 5. 56 divided by 5, it is 11.2. Another last one, the total product is 57 and labor they have used is 6. So 57 divided by 6, how much is going to be? It is going to be 9.5. So here it comes 11.2, here 9.5. So like this you completed your table. So in exam for 4 marks they will ask, they will give the total product. You have to find out the marginal product of the labor and average product of the labor. If you seen, when the output is 0, the marginal product and total product will be also 10, same. As the output increases, as the output goes on increasing, what happens? The average product is going to be reduced and marginal product of the labor also going to be reduced. So this is about the calculation of the total product, marginal product and average product. So how to find out total product? So now we have only average product or average product in your hand. How to find out the total product? It is simple. If you are having only average product, what you have to do? How you calculated average product? Total product divided by L. So if you do this, it will come into L. So if you turn it out, so average product is equal to total product divided by L. Now you have to find out total product. So keep it like that only. Average product, it is divided by, when it come to this side, it will be into L is equal to what remaining total product is remained. So like that also you have to find out. So this is homework for you. So apply this formula and find out the total product. So how you have to find out for total product? You have to use the formula average product into L is equal to total product. Apply this formula and try it out. When you are doing 10 into 1 is equal to 10. Next, 12 into 2, how much it will come? 24. 13.33 into 3, how much it will come? You have to calculate and see whether it is coming as a tally. So thank you student, I hope you are clear with this calculation. Do it by yourself. If you are having any doubt, you can ask with me. So take a table, the numbers you take, and calculate once again. So thank you student.